Hey guys, this is Epic Zacko, and with my new film Continuity War Part 2 almost here, I decided it was about time to update that old timeline video I made all the way back in 2018. In this video, we're going to discuss everything you need to know before watching this epic multiverse-sized crossover movie. And the first things we need to talk about are the two playlists you can choose from to watch the videos leading to Continuity War. In 2018, there were three choices of playlists, but now I've narrowed it down to just two. The first playlist and the one I'd recommend for most people is Continuity War, the Abridged Story. This is the one I'd recommend for any newcomers trying to get caught up or longtime fans who just need a quick refresher. Clocking in at just over 2 hours, this playlist has all the videos you'll need to watch to understand parts 1 and 2 of the film. Nothing less and nothing more. But if you have way too much time on your hands and you want to watch, well, everything, then the playlist for you is Continuity War, the Complete Story. Clocking in at almost 4 hours, this playlist has every video leading to the events of Continuity War. So basically, the abridged list has just what you need to watch, and the complete list has everything. Now on to the main event, the Epic Zacko Cinematic Multiverse, or ECM for short. The ECM operates very similarly to something like, say, the Marvel Cinematic Universe, in that it's a bunch of films, or in this case, YouTube videos, that all connect in some way. There are 10 universes in the Epic Zacko Cinematic Multiverse, and while not all of them have been explored in our videos, they are all at stake in the events of Continuity War. Each universe has its own timeline, and we're gonna start off by talking about the one that our main character comes from, the modern Epic Zacko universe. Our story begins in 2006 in the video Lego Zack and Troy. In this video, Zack and Troy were just kids in elementary school and they didn't have their superpowers yet. In Zack's first act of heroism, he saved his classmates' Legos from being destroyed by the class bully Sean, who ended every sentence with Fast forward to the year 2012 with the events of Epic Zacko Prologue. Now Zack has donned the Epic suit and thus gained his superpowers and the title Epic Zacko. Troy still didn't have any powers yet, but he did have a bike that goes super speed. They'd been fighting crime together for about a year when one day they heard about a government break-in done by an Epic Zacko imposter. The imposter stole a briefcase holding a bomb powerful enough to destroy the entire planet. How can they fit that in a briefcase? Well, you're gonna have to ask young me, cause I have no idea. Anyway, Epic Zacko and Epic Troy had to do something, but neither one trusted the other one to handle the briefcase properly, leading to the events of Zack and Troy. In this video, our heroic duo has its first civil fight to decide who would handle the briefcase. Meanwhile, in another dimension called the Cartoon Dimension, that's right, another dimension but not another universe, we're introduced to two stick men called Bob and Derek. In 2012, in the video Bob Stole My Cookie, notorious cookie thief Bob decided to steal a cookie from Derek, and Derek was not too happy about that. Murderous hijinks ensued, which leads us to the events of Bob Meets Sonic, which are exactly what the name implies. One day, while being chased by Derek, Bob ran into the likes of Sonic the Hedgehog. And now we're gonna come back to the real world dimension, because in 2015, something major happened. Our four superpowered heroes were brought together by a government agent to form an alliance and save the city from an evil alien who also happens to be the main nemesis of one of the heroes in the events of Marvel's The Avengers, the Epic Zacko movie. I was 14, give me a break. An epic battle ensued between the newly formed Epic Zacko team and the evil forces of Dr. Eggman, Android Derek, and fake Epic Zacko. And about a year after that, during Zack's last day of high school, the events of Continuity War began. So that's the modern Epic Zacko universe taken care of, but you may be wondering why it's called that. And the reason may shock you. See, the Epic Zacko movie we were just talking about was actually a remake of another, much shorter Epic Zacko movie I made several years earlier, and the Epic Zacko from the original movie resides in the classic Epic Zacko universe. The classic Epic Zacko universe is largely the same story as the modern one, so there's no need to go over it again. The only major difference is the omission of Lego Zack and Troy in Epic Zacko Prologue. Classic Epic Zacko will be making his first appearance since 2013 in Continuity War Part 2, which we're super excited about. Before we get into the big stuff, let's talk very quickly about the Zack and Troy universe. Zackiverse, named after the video series of the same name. The Zack and Troy series has 7 numbered entries, a Christmas special, and 2 spin-off videos. But the only thing we're going to talk about here is the video Zack and Troy Power Outage. In this video, an unpopular YouTuber called Power Taker decided that since he couldn't outdo his competition to become popular, he'd take away their electricity instead to stop them from uploading videos. The Power Taker makes an appearance in Continuity War Part 1. An interesting side note about this universe is that it's the only one in which the nighttime battle of Zack and Troy 1 is canon. Alright, now things are gonna get a little more complicated. It's time to talk about the Flash Game Reviews universe, which has a bit of a split timeline going on. But first you may be wondering what Flash Game Reviews even is. Flash Game Reviews was a series we made a few years ago. It was sort of an angry video game nerd discovers Flash games type of thing. In each episode, Troy and I would find a bunch of shitty Flash games on the internet to pick apart. This universe is split into 2 parallel timelines. Both timelines begin with episode 1, but after that, things start to get interesting. In timeline 1, Zack and Troy discovered 3 Mario Flash games that were so bad, the devs decided to take them down and hide the files on discs in a mad science storage room. For some reason. This leads to the events of episode 1.5 and episode 2, in which Zack and Troy go on a quest to find and review the 3 games. In timeline 2, however, Zack and Troy never had the desire to go after the games, so episodes 1.5 and 2 never happened in that timeline. Now bear with me, cause this is where shit gets weird. So at the end of episode 2, Troy found a letter that said to destroy the 3 discs to save the world, which he then did. But after doing so, it released an evil wizard named Crow, who looks exactly like Zack. Crow basically said, "Yeah, you messed up. And now, I'm going to rewrite reality the way I want it." Which leads directly into the events of Continuity War. After some shenanigans that I won't spoil in Continuity War Part 1, the Troy from Timeline 1 of the Flash Game Reviews universe ended up getting sent to Timeline 2, where episodes 3 and 4 happen. Whew! Alright, now we're past the confusing stuff. There's one more character's timeline to talk about, but unlike the others, this character's timeline is not confined to one universe. And the reason for that will become apparent shortly. In the events of Chris Prologue, a motivationally drained comic writer named Chris was trying to write his next story when his whole world got turned upside down. Someone called the author, and that's me, that's like literally me from real life who wrote the stories, so it's gonna be weird for a minute because I'm gonna be talking about myself in the third person, basically. Someone called the author contacted him from the sky and gave him a device that can teleport him to other universes. The author told Chris to become part of his story, and Chris basically said, "Screw that," but the author pretty much forced him to do it anyway by teleporting him automatically. Yeah, I'm kind of a dick like that. From then on, Chris teleported from universe to universe, and in each one, he was given a new role in whatever storyline was unfolding there. He went to several different universes in Chris Prologue, and towards the end of that video, he was sent to a universe where Zack was conducting a Let's Play. Chris took on the role of a YouTube employee trying to stop Zack from cursing in his videos, and then basically took over his house. After that, he was sent back to his home universe, but now he's gotta help Zack find the ghost of Harambe. Yes, that Harambe. And afterwards, they both had to fight a war against Chris's Legos that came to life and wanted him dead. Unfortunately, that war didn't go so well for the two of them. The Legos managed to build the Extinction Cannon, a cannon designed to kill all humans. With 10 seconds left, Chris frantically shot the cannon with a slingshot, but all that did was knock it over, causing it to blow up half the planet. Oops. This next part was never seen in the video, but it turns out Chris survived the blast. How? Well, at the literal last second, the universe teleportation device appeared before him and teleported him out automatically. This landed him in the Flash Game Reviews universe just in time for the events of Episode 2, which, as we already know, lead directly into the events of Continuity War. But what is Continuity War anyway? Well, aside from it being the culmination of all these videos I've just talked about, it's a huge crossover film. The main characters from all these stories come together to stop Crow from hijacking reality and converging the multiverse. Me, Troy, Chris, and everyone else involved put a lot of work in to make Continuity War the best it can be. So if this whole thing sounds interesting to you, we would greatly appreciate you checking out Part 2 when it comes out on December 4th. And until then, be sure to watch the video studios leading to it as well. Continuity War is going to be a 4-part film, so if you end up liking it, then be sure to subscribe so you won't miss the future parts. With that being said, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you again December 4th. This is Epic Zacko signing out. Have a good one.